a sudden, what the heck happened? They got a 2-hour U.S. Postal Service worker who was a whistleblower. Now, for anyone who followed this, there was a whistleblower, and he said we were trained to toss out ballots. We were trained to commit fraud. We were threatened. Then this guy was interviewed by a U.S. Postal Service inspector, like a Fed, basically, because it's from the IG office. So he's a federal agent of the government coming to talk to him about what he saw. Based upon some of that, the Washington Post went to print and said he rescinded it all, which he didn't. So they were, well, they haven't been, I mean, caught lying. They lie all the time, I guess. But I just want to play just a minute or two. We can stop whenever you want, of this postal worker who somehow he got in touch with Project Veritas. I don't know the backstory on that. They wired him. John, this is possibly the best record. You don't even hear undercover recordings from the feds like this. This is so good. And to hear this, you'll hear this. His name is Russell Strasser. He is the post office worker the inspector who was there to convince this guy that he didn't see what he saw. And that it didn't happen that way, and that he's possibly mistaken. It's 2 hours long, but just to give you an idea of how horrible these people are, listen to what this guy is doing with this postal worker.
Hi, sir. Are you Richard?
Yes.
Hi, Richard. My name is Russ Strasser. You want to come in for a second?
Buckle.
I don't want people to be looking and whatnot. Hi.
It's been pretty rough.
I bet it's been incredibly rough. I want to tell you a few things. I want to tell you who I am, why I'm asking to speak with you, and sort of lay it out for you.
Right.
Okay? And we didn't expect you to be here. So
I'm not willing to give up until they fire me.
Good for you, by the way. Good for you.
Yeah.
But I literally was under the wrong information. And so what I'm apologizing for is I'm not quite ready for you yet, because I thought that we'd have to wait for you to come in.
We thought we'd have to drag you in handcuffs, is what he's saying here.
So I apologize if this looks a little haphazard. It's just I didn't realize you would be here. So
here you go.
I'm actually thrilled that you're here. I'm going to say the first thing, with respect to you, with this whole COVID thing, if you'd rather me have a mask,
I don't care.
I don't either. And so
this is I love this kind of virtue signaling. This is very typical. This is nice to hear it on tape, on recording. It's like, just with respect to the COVID thing, I mean, what he basically wants to say is, should we take off our masks because of this bullcrap thing that is not true, that we both don't believe in, and we're faking it here right in front of each other? Which, of course, shouldn't be said by some inspector guy, but he does.
With respect to you, with this whole COVID thing, if you'd rather me have a mask,
I don't care.
I don't either. And so,
okay.
But I want you to know that you can drive that bus if you say, Russ, put a mask on.
I want you to know you can drive that bus.
I want that I can put on. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, if you don't mind, I'd rather not wear these damn things.
I'm okay with that, too. When we leave here, I've got my mask on, so
they don't get mad at me.
They don't get mad at me. Exactly. Okay. So let me tell you who I am and why I'm here. You love to know why I'm here.
Yes.
The last week has been crazy, right?
Listen to this guy. Am I mistaken that this guy is trying to, he's pulling out all the stops on this poor postal worker to basically coerce him into whatever this guy wants him to say?
You might be. I guess he seems nervous and unprepared. I don't know. Just let it play.
Oh, no, I already killed it. If you don't think it's just nervous and stuff, I think it's a little more than that.
On. I have one that I can't.
There we go.
Let me tell you who I am and why I'm here. You love to know why I'm here.
Yes.
The last week has been crazy, right?
The only reason I came out forward, I'm an introverted person, don't like to be noticed.
I'm there with you. I understand.
But as soon as I started realizing they knew it was me, and they came with an allegation, a PDI from months ago, like June, August, and they were like, yeah, we need to get that statement. I was like, dude, I gave you that statement.
So, here's where we're at right now, okay? I'm going to make a promise to you right now. I'm going to be 100% upfront with you the entire time you're with me. Okay? You ask me a question, I promise to answer you. And I promise to answer you honestly.
All right.
Whether it's good for me, bad for you, I will be honest with you. That's my first promise up to you, okay? And so let me make good on that promise right away, okay? This storm is getting crazy, right? And it's out of a lot of people's control. And so the reason they called me in is to try to harness that storm, try to reel it back in before it gets really crazy.